In this video, I'll show you the awesome doll hoses I got. This video is also posted on our other channel, Thrift Shop Hop. So if you want to make comments, go over there. I bought this dollhouse before the lockdown. It's the Calico Critters Deluxe Village House. I got it for $14.99. Then I found this lot for $25 on Facebook Marketplace. And that's not all. I found this Cloverleaf Manor and ice cream shop also on Facebook Marketplace. I'll give you a closer look at these Calico Critter houses later. And the best dollhouse I got is this one. I got it free from Rosie's neighbor. Oh my gosh, so awesome. Look, it has its own turntable. Check out the inside. There's a few things that need to be repaired. It's really well built, so it's worth fixing up. It has so much potential. I'm gonna make this house for Strawberry Shortcake. It's the perfect size for her. Can't wait to transform this house. It's gonna be fun. And I got another dollhouse for free. This one from Facebook Marketplace. It's solid pine. Looks like the staircase was moved. Yep, see the holes in the floor? The staircase used to be right in the middle. Staircase is really getting in the way. It's much better against the wall. I put it on a turntable just for this video. Let's have a look. Door on the side. There's another one on the other side. Okay, so I guess this would be the front, but there's no front door. I couldn't put one in even if I wanted to, because the stairs are right here. Oh well, if the house is against the wall, it won't matter. Look at the wood grain. It's beautiful. I would never cover it up. I don't know what doll this house was made for. It could work for Strawberry Shortcake, but the door is too short. Only goes up to here on her. She's taller than the door. Here we are upstairs. This window's a tad too low. But look at this window. It's way too high. However, the door is the perfect size for Calico Critters. Easy peasy. Although, the house seems a bit too big. Check this out. The window is way too high. They'd have to jump to look out. It's way over their head. I'd have to make them a fake lower window or cover it up. Who do you think I should make this house for? Strawberry Shortcake and her friends, or Calico Critters? If you think of another doll that this house would be suited for, let me know. Go over to the Thrift Shop Hop channel and post your answer in the comments section. Okay, this is the Calico Critter house I bought before the lockdown. There's the price sticker. It's faded because I had to buy a window. Some parts are missing, like the railings that go up here, and the ones that go on the side, and the front steps. No big deal. I can make new railings. I put it on turntable so I could spin it, whether it's for playing or displaying. It definitely comes in handy. And let's have a look at the inside. This is in great condition. I was really lucky to get these railings. Railings and stairs are usually missing. And for good reason, too. It's because they get in the way of playing, so they're often removed. This opening on the side is great. It gives you another access to the back of the house. Inside, there are placeholders for ceiling lights. Top floor, there are three holders and three on the lower floor. The light fixtures are missing, but I can figure something out. Okay, back to the front. See how easy these rails come off? So easy to lose, too. And it's really hard to find replacement parts. This house is made for calico critters. See? Perfect! The Cloverleaf Manor, also known as the Grand Hotel. This is the one I got off Facebook Marketplace. I'll show you the ice cream shop another time. I got it cheap because so many parts were missing. One of the doors is missing. I could make another door. The front steps are missing. Windows are beautiful. Look at the details on these doors. Wow. Pretty sure there's supposed to be a balcony with rails up here, held up by white columns. Look at this. Such a pretty stained glass window. If this house was against a wall, no one would care that the balcony's missing. Side of the house, lots of windows. This is the back, and this is where it opens up. Woohoo! Look at this! 3 floors of grandness. 9 rooms in total. I could totally see this as a grand hotel. This is the lot I got from Facebook Marketplace. Everything for $25. This is the same house I got from Valley Village for $14. It's the Calico Critters Deluxe Village House. This is the red roof townhouse. And this is the one room cottage. And this is the horse stable. Okay, inside. All the rails are missing except for that one. This is a stable. I didn't even know Calico Critters had horses. This is the one room cottage. This is the front, but there's no door. Here's the side with a window. They make a few stores like this. This is more like the front. You just walk right up to it. The red roof townhouse. This has been redesigned so that you could stack more rooms on top. The railings are missing. The deck is so narrow that the railings really get in the way of playing. The staircase is missing, but that gets in the way too. Half the platform is missing. There's supposed to be a dividing wall here, but let me tell you, when this is all fixed up, nobody will care about the missing pieces. All these houses will look fabulous, and they'll make great gifts for some very special people that I know. The first house I'm going to make over is this one. I'll show you the transformation in a series of videos called This Old Dollhouse. Can't wait to show you what I'm going to do to this house. Thanks for watching, and see you again soon. If you like this video, give us a thumbs up. Check out this video. She can't even get through that door. Look at this. Boom, boom, boom. She has like crawl out. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.